Hey everybody, it's me Fadi, and welcome again to another episode of How to Build and Maintain a Reef Aquarium. Today, I speak about the different kinds of coral that are available for your reef aquarium. From the start of this series, I was speaking about different topics, including tank setup, filtration, flow and lightening, all of which are required to keep a healthy and thriving reef tank. And what makes the aquarium a reef tank is the assortment of corals that we keep in it. Corals are the major contributor for the physical structure of the coral reefs. Corals are marine invertebrates that typically live in combat colonies of many identical individual polyps. Polyps can live individually, like many mushrooms corals do, or in large colonies that can make up an entire reef structure. A polyp has a sac-like body and an opening or mouth surrounded by stinging tentacles. The polyps use calcium and carbonate ions from seawater to build itself a hard skeleton made up of calcium carbonate. This skeleton protects the soft and delicate body of the polyp. Coral polyps are usually nocturnal, meaning that they stay inside the skeleton during the day. At night, polyps extend their tentacles to feed. Most coral polyps have clear bodies and their skeletons are white. Generally, their brilliant color comes from the zooxanthellae living inside their tissues. Zooxanthellae produce pigments inside the coral tissues. These pigments are visible through the clear body of the polyp and are what gives coral its beautiful color. Photosynthetic corals require sunlight and usually grow in clear, shallow water, typically less than 200 feet. Other corals that don't rely on zooxanthellae can be found much deeper. Corals can be categorized into two categories: soft corals and hard corals. Soft corals have no solid skeleton. However, their tissues are often reinforced by small supportive elements known as krillates made up of calcium carbonate. Some examples of soft corals are leathers, zinnia, mushrooms, zooanthids, glove, star polyps. In general, soft corals are some of the easiest corals to take care for and the fastest to grow, with a few exceptions like non-photosynthetic carnation corals. Soft corals, like zooanthids, can come in many amazing colors. That's what makes them very popular among many reefers. Most soft corals do well in a light to medium flow and light, so I usually place them in the corners of the tank or under overhangs. Some soft corals, like zooanthids, mushrooms, and GSP, can turn into a problem. They are very fast to grow and may overgrow other surrounding corals and kill them. To avoid that, you can place them on a dedicated island to prevent them from spreading all over the tank. Soft corals do better in nutrient-rich water. Nutrient-rich water doesn't mean dirty water. That means that there are enough nutrients and food for the coral to feed. And here are some of the easy care soft corals that you can keep in your tank. The second type of corals is stony corals. The skeletons are made of calcium carbonate in the form of clasite and aragonite. Stony corals can be categorized under two subcategories: LPS corals, or large polyp stony corals, and SPS corals, or small polyp stony corals. LPS have large and fleshy polyps. Some LPS can live alone as a single large polyp, like Sculimia, Fongia, known as blade coral. Many types of LPS have easy to moderate care requirements. They need low to moderate light in addition to moderate flow. they also like some nutrients in the water. And you can see some LPS actually grabbing food and eating it, like akens, blastos, and scolies. These LPS will benefit from target feeding with special coral food like polyplab rhephroids. Gunipora corals will do better when target feeding it with two little fishes gunipora. The coral food may contribute in faster growth, better coloration, and more fleshy appearance for the coral. However, some reefers don't target feed the corals and rely on broadcast feeding or food leftovers from fish food. If you are going to feed your corals, try not to overfeed. I feel that one time weekly is enough. If you have a heavy feeding schedule and a lot of fish, it may be not needed to feed the corals. In addition, I wouldn't feed a coral unless it's showing some feeding reaction and actually eating the coral food. Some of the LPS will extend sweeping tentacles while feeding or at night. Some LPS corals, like Gunipora, will extend very long polyps that may touch and kill other nearby corals. So you should keep enough space between LPS corals so they don't touch, sting, and kill each other. And here are some of the easy to medium to care LPS corals that you can add to your aquarium. SPS corals or small polyp stony corals are somehow more difficult than LPS and softies. SPS corals can be very sensitive to changes in water parameters and temperature. SPS corals comes in a wide variety of corals and shapes. They can be branching, tabling, plating, or encrusting. SPS in general needs high flow and high light. Some of the SPS available are Acropora, Montipora, Oscillipora, Stylopora, Ceratopora, or bird nest. Acropora corals are my favorite corals ever. And as you can see, my tank is full of them. Some of my favorites are strawberry shortcake, red dragon, Acropora luribus, Aura red planet, bonsai, pale green slimer, rainbow shortcake, Acropora lucani, and iflo. Acros in general are the hardest SPS to keep, and they need continuous addition of calcium and carbonate to build their skeletons. Montipora corals comes in all shapes and colors. Some can be plating like Monte caps, some are encrusting like this Grinch Monte, some are branching like Digitata, and some grows in a combination of all growth types like Montipora setosa, and that's why Montipora setosa is my favorite Montipora. Montes are easier to keep compared to Acros, and I recommend to try Montipora first before jumping into Acropora. That's it for today. Next week, I'll speak about how to add corals to your tank and how to place them. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and see you soon in the next video.